back to my channel. Today, I'm sharing super easy activities that you can do with your toddler with like the most minimal prep work and just using things that you had around the house. Literally, I did not buy anything for these activities. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you do, make sure you give it a thumbs up, leave a comment down below about what is your favorite activity, and don't forget to subscribe so you don't miss any more content just like this. This first one is all around color sorting. Take that egg carton that you have before you toss it, reuse it for this next activity. I had a plastic one that we didn't end up using, so that's what I used, but you can use any kind of egg carton that you have. All I did is I put some colorful dotted stickers on the bottom. You can literally cut out colored paper and just tape it. And then we have these pom-poms. You can use balls. You can just use any kind of toy that you have. And basically Ellie will just go through and sort these. We have this actually in our kitchen where she can access it, and she pulls this out at least a few times a week. We've added a wooden spoon just to help her play around with it more, or like tongs throughout. And this is super easy and one that we keep coming back to. Another great item to repurpose for color matching is those pouch lids. So anytime we have a pouch, I actually have a little container that I keep all of them. And this is what you can use for different color sorting. We're also gonna use this in two big bowls, one with water, and she'll kind of shift them back and forth. She'll use a spoon, it works on our motor skills. We can talk about the colors, count, all of those things. Great way to repurpose them. Now let's shift our focus to those super cute babies. For this one, all you need is a colander and some pipe cleaners. I just string some through and let Sammy play with them. As you can see, he truly enjoyed this one. This is a great one, especially if you want to practice sitting with your baby and just, you know, letting them explore new things and play around. All right, these next few require just like a little bit of prep work. This I call a popsicle stick puzzle. You'll just grab a few popsicle sticks, stick some tape on the back, and then flip it over and draw any kind of picture on the front. I am not the most artistic person, so I went with a nice house. I added a door, some windows, a sun, you know, whatever makes it very clear that this is a house. This picture was a little complicated for my daughter at first, but after a while she got it. And then once you're done, just take the tape off and let your kid play with this as if it's a puzzle. This is also really neat with letters. So as your kid is learning to read, you can draw, let's say, a car and then put C-A-R. And then they can, with the puzzle, they can also put the letters in order together. Next, we're gonna make a sensory bottle. This is definitely geared more towards my baby or my almost 1 year old, but I'm sure my toddler will love this and steal it from him any chance she gets. To make your very own sensory bottle, you'll need a plastic bottle and then just fill it halfway up with some water. For this one, I am gonna add some food coloring just to make it more exciting, but really a few drops goes a long way. Make sure you seal it nice and tight and then shake it up. Then we will go ahead and add some fun things into our sensory bottle. I'm using water beads, but you can really use any kind of little toy, glitter, sparkles, whatever you want. Just if you are gonna use the water beads, watch them because they like to jump all over the place. Lastly, we'll add a little bit of corn syrup. This makes the liquid inside move a little bit slower and just gives it that nice effect. And lastly, fill it up with water all the way up, and voila, there is your sensory bottle. I didn't have as many things added inside into mine, so I think in the next time I would add a few more. And my last tip is that the Vaz water bottles do make the best sensory bottles, but again, I just used whatever I had and just let them play with it. As you can see, Sammy is intrigued and seeing what it's all about. These next few are all around repurposing those cardboard boxes for some fun activities before you put them in the recycling bin. We are gonna go ahead and make our very own shape sorter. And as you can see, we are back to my amazing artistic abilities, and clearly I can only draw houses. So what I did is inside my house, I drew different shapes like a triangle, a rectangle, a circle, and I think something that's supposed to be an oval. Then you're gonna go ahead and cut each of these pieces out. And my tip is once you cut them out, go ahead and trim them a little bit with scissors so that they're easier to fit through the holes. And then just let your toddler find the right piece that is supposed to fit through each hole. Our last activity is probably our favorite one, and this is what we call the nail salon. For this one, you'll want to go ahead and grab a flat piece of cardboard and just trace both of your hands on it. I'm using a Sharpie here, but that probably wasn't the safest idea. So I'll trace both of my hands and then I'll draw a little line to indicate the part of the nail. Lastly, I'll go ahead and stick some packing tape on top, and the reason for that is when Ellie starts painting this, it actually makes it so you can wipe off the paint and then start all over, and just makes the activity last a little bit longer. You definitely don't have to do this, but like I said, it just makes the activity last a little bit longer. Anytime we're painting in our house, we definitely put on this little smock for Ellie. It just makes it so her clothes don't get as dirty. I absolutely love it, and I'll link it off of Amazon. And I just gave her this little set of Crayola paint and a little cup with some water, and just let her enjoy and paint the cardboard, again paint the nails, and then she will use a little rag to wipe off the paint and start all over. This activity actually lasts a decent amount of time, and so I love to do Ellie's hair while she's preoccupied.
And with that, those are my super easy and frugal activities that you can put together in less than 30 seconds, just reusing things that you already had around your house, and your kids will still have a blast, they will learn something new, and they'll be preoccupied for a little bit, so you can put dinner together or just enjoy that cup of coffee while it's still hot. I hope you enjoyed this video and try out some of these activities. As always, let me know if you do, whether it's on Instagram or in the comments below. Don't forget to give this video a thumbs up and consider subscribing so you don't miss any more videos just like this one. And I will see you in my next one. Bye.
Me pa my boogie.
Bless you.